Well, welcome, Garden River House. Tonight, I'm going to be making, a wool insulated sitting pad. You might not recognize me, I'm wearing my contacts today. I don't have glasses on. Oh. I assure you, it's still me. Still the same guy. So, I'm gonna be making just a nice place to sit in the woods, is the idea. So, I have exactly the right amounts of fabric, I think. So I have this left over from the piece that I cut yesterday for the other pieces. And then I have this much bias binding it. So I'm going to do a folded hem on two sides of this piece, and then the bias tape on the other two sides. I'm going to do the long sides for the bias tape. I'll make it more of a square, and then it'll all match nicely. And so I'm going to be cutting into my new fabric for the first time here pretty soon. Started here pretty soon, I think. Trying to figure out this stream manager thing. There we go. Send this out to a couple people. Gonna get started here in just a minute. Gonna get going. All right. Hope everyone had a nice day. I'm gonna put a couple things away. Get started, otherwise it'll just continue to get too messy. Such good luck with meeting cool people on Craigslist. I think buying things on Craigslist is going to be just my new official way to make friends, because everyone I meet on there has hobbies that are matching mine, so it's kind of fun to be able to do that. Garden River House, we're able to get the casting to work to the TV. This is my new design for utility roll. I forgot to get my drill outside one more time. But I'm gonna put some grommets in these corners so that you can hang it up on a tree. So we got this new fabric, and I'm just so excited about it. Nope, that's not all, folks. That's from yesterday. We got some new fabric. And it's this awesome purple stuff. Flip this around. So, what we're making today is going to be part of this set that we have over here of the roll top, or the utility roll, and then the roll top bags. And what it's going to be is, on one side, we're going to have this lovely waxed canvas, so it's nice and waterproof and durable. And then on the other side is going to be this really nice wool fabric. So, these are, they sometimes call them like bushcraft blankets, but the idea is to have like one really nice, somewhat warm, somewhat soft and dry spot to sit in the woods. So I'll be assembling that. I've really wanted to make one of these for a while, and I finally have the materials that I need to do it. And so I have this bias tape that I made the other day. I've used it on the other project. So this is wax canvas as well that I got in a chocolate brown color. I have enough of it to go this length. So I'm going to do the long edges are going to be with the bias tape, and then the short edges are going to be a gold hem. So I'm going to do a 1-inch hem on both of these. So what I need to do now is figure out, so I know that I need fabric this wide, so, but I'm probably going to need about 2 inches less. And so what might end up happening is, let's see how long this actually is, because I might just cut it in half so that it's easier to repurpose for other things. It's not the exact right color that I want, but you know what? It was cheap and is very nice material, so who cares about the color? And also, there's plenty of nice things that are purple, so. So it is a, looks like a 51-inch bolt. And so I need almost exactly half, so. So half of 51 is 25 and a half. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it in half first. Well, I'm going to cut down this length, and then I'll cut it in half so that I can make another item like that without as much waste. Kind of nice to have half of the bolt. So the trickiest thing with this is going to be getting this to be a straight cut. I'm so used to waxed canvas that's easy to cut and make marks on. This is going to be a little bit more challenging. I just need to make sure that I'm getting right angles. And it should be okay. So So I think the first step is going to be getting this end over here to be straight. Our friend that we got this from on Craigslist, like the last cut might not have been the straightest, so we're going to do our best to resolve that. Not saying that I'm perfect either, but it's a good first step. And so I'm eyeballing a right angle here. Also looking at the weave, and I'm going to try to not cut across the weave all that much. If I can, it's kind of hard to see, but I'm not showing too much butt crack. Oh no, all the butt crack. Sorry, everybody. Top of the ruler. So nice, very nice and soft. I think that's 85% wool, according to the website, 15% polyester, or acrylic, or what have you. Okay, so now we're gonna run. We mostly got this measurement right. Just gotta line up the two. Make sure it's a relatively straight line. Perfectly straight line is, of course, better, but I wanna get it done. This might not be exactly perfect. We're gonna try. Don't have a good posterior for keeping pants up, and so doing this kind of stuff is just bound to get some butt crack. That looks fairly straight. So oh yeah, we're gonna do 25.5. Because that's perfectly in half. This ruler. If you're doing any sewing with a full bolt like this, or any sewing in general, I highly recommend getting a 72-inch ruler, 72-inch straight edge from, I got this from Menards, and it has made all of these sewing projects way better that I've had it. And it was not expensive. I would say it's a key component to a good sewing kit. I could also just fold in half. I might want to just double check that we have this in half right. This project is gonna go so fast. Now I need to decide. I also got some of this the other day. This is a wool moving blanket, but I'm not sure how much it's actually wool. So I think I'm considering putting this like a layer of this as like a batting to make it a little bit thicker. Although that makes it less packable, so I'm just gonna have to decide here in a little bit if that's something I want to do. So, real simple. I'm just gonna use this 1-inch rule as my guide. I wouldn't need to do this big of a seam or of a fold, but I like it. I'm gonna have grommets in here, which I'm planning on it. It kind of gives enough room to. I should have asked the guy I bought this from if there's a right side to this. Oh right, I need to cut this down for a bit. I forgot. So it's the right width there. Looks right, but I did make it a little bit too long. So I'm going to cut out another piece. Some of this other wool. I'm gonna get this marked first. Oh my gosh, I know, I'm so excited about it. It's really nice. You should start thinking about anything you would like with it. Could definitely make you some nice mitts or something like that. What do you think, Garden River House? Should I do a do the backing fabric with this other wool moving blanket, or should I just stick with the purple? Fewer layers. Things can be done too fast. I think I should do this other layer. It's cheap. This whole thing was $6 for this big blanket. It's a nice piece of felt. I'm not sure about its wool content, but stretches just a little bit, so wonder what would happen. This is definitely not a washable thing, unfortunately. Pretty thick, but I think we should still be fine with the presser foot. I have to just manually cycle it in a couple spots. Oh, I wonder if I should leave this bias tape a little long. There's like these little ties at the end. That could be kind of cool. You could use that to button it up maybe. Yeah, I think we'll do that. Kind of nice. Hell, you could even stake it down. Well, it is a little heavy. It does have a bunch of clamps on it, so maybe that's to be fair. I'm gonna clip these sides as well, just to make sure nothing moves on me. Thank you. lovely spot to sit. Okay. I think that's it. Mostly the whole deal. Not exactly complicated. I think my bobbin's in pretty good shape. I just replaced it not too long ago. Although, quite honestly, I'm probably going to use the whole darn thing. Oh. Never mind. That was the end of the bobbin. Very glad I didn't start. Peeved. So I can put it in the carriage, slip it in with the tail part facing up. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go along the tough. I'm gonna go along the edge here first. The folded hem, not the bias tape hem. Just to like get this out of the way. And I don't know if I want to go all the way around or just do like a couple different sets. Track it along this edge of the presser foot. And I'm gonna do a left seam. That'll get me a little bit closer to that edge. And make sure to reverse stitch. Here. I'm trying to keep it nice and flat. first stitch is done. And it looks pretty awesome. It's looking pretty good. Here's the first stitch. Nice and puffy. I'm going to do another stitch in the back just to double hem it, double seam it. Next, I'm going to roll up this side and do the same thing on the other clamped side just to get this pinned in on both edges. Clip here was getting caught on the edge of the sewing machine. I don't have more of an overhead view of what I'm doing. Kind of just see the individual stitches, but helps a little bit. Okay, got those two edges done. Feel pretty good about it. You know, mostly. So pulled a little weird, but I think it'll work out. Bunching a little bit. Hey, this is looking pretty slick. Looks like it captured all the material. Pretty good. Yeah, it's not perfect, because like, this is just canvas right here. And then over here, it's like canvas and all the materials. So the bias tape wasn't like lined up perfectly, but I think it'll be good enough. Let's go take a look at this on the table just to show you where I'm at so far. And so this is what we have so far. We have one more seam to go. And then we're going to be doing some grommets and stuff. Very interested to see if I screwed up my measurements and stuff while sewing. So this is 21 across there, and that's like 20 and a quarter versus 21. So definitely did get it too small on this end, but I'll have to practice a little bit more with this like multimedia situation. Underneath is getting just a little squirrely. I don't know if it's getting pulled in a weird way, but I think I'll still capture it, but it should still be okay. This thing's pretty freaking cool. Not too heavy. Let's just go through some cool threads. Thank you. Well, that's the simplest seam that I could have done for that, I think. I'd really been thinking about doing more complicated seams, but I think this super works. So I want to do some thinking about how to store this. Pretty bulky. Figure out how this is gonna roll so that I can put the buttons and stuff in the right spot. Check all these seams before I pull around on it a whole bunch, huh? Totally, yeah, that one's way off, isn't it? So I'm gonna need to put another stitch closer to the edge, which is kind of what I was planning on doing, but I'm just gonna go we'll be right back. great on that part, but I did not get this in. Crap. Gonna have to do a little bit of manual stuff over here. Not my favorite. Good thing it's a gift. So, new plan, next time, I'm going to sew the wool together, whatever the liner material is, I'm going to sew it together with the wool, and then cut it after, so it all lines up perfectly with my bottom cloth, would be probably the best bet. Probably just do all three of them at once. Okay, back to what I was doing. In on itself once, and then roll. Yeah, that's the thing. Ah, jeez. So much thinking. I've concluded that these are useless. These like ends here. I don't think that they're actually going to be good for anything. Should be good. I don't know, you guys. Well, I could do a bag that's attached to it. I could use a spare bit of fabric to use as like a flap or a tie. I could do nothing. I could just like tie it up, but I kind of want it to be like a nice system. Buddy, you can focus. Too bad to get in a pack. So what I need to do is incorporate a tie somewhere. I'm just gonna do folding, so I don't think we need to have some fancy system for this to work. I do really like the double seam. I'm gonna do a double seam on the blue as well. And the rest of the brown. Maybe I'll leave the flaps, I'm not sure. It looks like we're missing a little bit here. It's kind of a little too close, I have to do another seam on that side. Thank you. be pretty close. Kind of want to get rid of these flaps. I don't think they're going to do anything. They're kind of just extra. Started that last line, I forgot to hold on to my back thread, and you see we have this little rat's nest because of that. So it's not great to do that. It's probably not quite as strong because it's like trying to fight your bobbin thread instead of pulling tight, actually. So pull just some of the spare thread out and slip it. Folding it in thirds. I wouldn't want to do that because this part would be dirty. You really would just want to do like fold it in half on itself so the nice sides are touching each other. And then we can do half. Yeah, okay. So I definitely have learned while making this that you don't want the extra bulk from the second piece of wool. I definitely would have made this just thinner because then it's easier to roll and stuff. So we could do... This is still nice sides together. Fold in thirds. Yeah, that seems right. This is good. So I'm going to clip these ends off and I'm going to just do a little hem on it. On these ends, just a quick, you know, 1-2 or something. And then I'm going to put some buttons so that it can stay closed when we roll it. My god, it's 9 p.m. already. bulky stitch. That is totally fine. That is all that I'm gonna need to do. Thank you.
Sorry.
The stitch got messed up, so I'm just going to start over before I get too far into it. Tack that in there a little bit. Folding it over just to get the edge finished there. Thank you. stingray. So fold the nice sides in. Line it up with that strap. Do it. Okay, so now take a drink of the hot water. Find the scratch all. Game I was playing last night that I didn't really like doing. This piece gets jammed all the time. Got it out. It chewed up in the process. Roll it up. Just like with anything, you just gotta keep it centered. Tuck in these hems there. And then snap. There we go. Should be pretty self-contained, pretty waterproof. And that, my friends, is the whole set. Ta-da! Pretty cool setup, I think. I'm not as happy with this pad as I thought it would be, but I think the second one I make will be better. Traveling, stick it in this bag. Cool. Well, that's all I got for today. That was very fun. Work on these projects. Excited to make more of these things. Gotta make sure to take some photos so that I remember how I did this. Watching. Hope you all had a nice time. I don't have any immediate projects. I kind of scrambled to get this done, so I'm probably not going to stream for another, probably a couple weeks, but maybe I'll get motivated and do some more. We'll see. Well, have a good night, and see you around.